Alright, welcome back to RPG Quest, and we are back with game number 64, which is Starflight on the Sega Genesis. So last time, I ran around getting minerals, and we ever shipped to the maximum we can get it, as far as I'm aware. So right now, I really have no leads, technically, but, I mean, we have a bunch of different notes I've taken, so I'm going to start following through them one by one, see if we can find some more information. Let's go through all these areas one by one and try to find more info, talk to more races, see if we can get some more information, and go from there. So let's start the game. Starflight. What's the last name I had? Is it one or did I save one, two? This thing I hate—it doesn't tell you when you last save these things. Let's see, 13, 11, 2, 4, 60, 20. 11, 2, 13, 13, 11, 0, 2. See if we get the other ones later or sooner. Okay, so the other one was newer, 13... 13, 11... This one's 3, 10... Alright, start the timer. Okay, so, I guess we're near home. Do we have any minerals to dump? Or I think all our cargo right now is just fuel. Engineer? Yeah. Yeah, we pick up the Dodecahedron, which we won't be able to fight, but I remember there's one of the notes mentioning that, you know, the whatever the hell they're called there, the lizard people were buying artifacts, so selling that to them is probably a good thing, because maybe that'll keep them from attacking. Which I might want to do that first, because I mean, looking at my map I made, I think they're pretty much south of us, or well, downspin of us, which we probably have a teleporter there, wormhole that goes like right to that area. I swear, half the time when you replay a game, you're like, "What's the controls again?" All right, so this one here would lead us pretty close to it. So this here would be their space here, I'm pretty sure. So we can teleport to this one and go here. Yeah, it's just being in the middle of their space. This one kind of leads to the Elowin, what I'm assuming is the Elowin area, because the Elowin and the Thrawn, or whatever the hell they're called, are fighting, and there's like an area right between these, like right between here where both of them overlap, so that would make sense that they'd be fighting in that area. That or the Elowin might be on this side, but I don't think I've met an Elowin on this side yet, so I think they're here, and then lizard guys are here. So this would be the most likely spot to find them. So yeah, let's use this one, and then this one. That brings us right to them. Where's the other disc? This one, I think. Easy lose track. Is that the right one? I think that was the right one. No, it's the wrong one. You want to do the one that was just northeast of it. Damn wormholes. This one right here. Okay. Alright, so now we should be in their area. So, let's see, is there any points of interest? I mean, our homeworld is probably like in this area here, one of these. So let's go to this one here actually. This looks like it'd be a place of contest between the two races. Friendly. Thrin. Yeah. Why do you heal us? Hey, Vayne. Because we want to sell you this nice dodecahedron. Navigator. Ray shields. I wonder how I'm supposed to sell this thing to them. Maybe I should dump my Elowin guys first. Like drop them off at the spaceship place and just like bring a couple Thrawn guys with us. Maybe, you know, force them to sell. I wonder if I should try that. You know, let's do that. Just to sell the dodecahedron, and then they won't be able to attack anymore. Assuming you can actually sell to them, I mean, from the sounds of it, that's pretty much what they're implying with one of the notes of the, one of the notes in the space station. That's what it kind of suggested doing. Saying there's Thrawn, they're like going around trying to buy artifacts, so. This one right here. Warships reported the Thrin have offered to buy artifacts, so. My question is, which one? But with Elowin on board, they seem to be very angry with us, so. So we don't really need a doctor, I mean, technically, so we can just, can I, can I add new members? Can I create nobody? No. I guess I can only create 5, so that's kind of annoying. I was hoping I could just, you know, create 2 more and then just dump these 2 and then pick them up after, but looks like you can only create 5 people. It's annoying. You can always like recreate them after, but nah, I don't want to do that. Screw the Thrin. Maybe we'll just get lucky and they won't attack us. Oops. Nope, stop. Of Sequis. Will you heal us? Because we want to sell this wonderful artifact. Damn it. Yeah, so right away they just attack, so. Yeah, so let's just forget trying to sell them this thing. Hey, Grunty. We'll just ignore them for now. probably not important anyways, or, well, they probably have some hints, but I don't want to be, like, dropping some party members just to make them happy. I don't want to be carrying around this, I want to be carrying around this artifact so I can't even shoot. Oops. Wrong spot. Cell. Decahedron. Okay. Alright, so yeah. So the closest... So look at my notes. The closest area that is a point of interest is just east of here. Is the area with the... how the androids were called there. The mechans. And we had a bunch of hints that kind of mention the mechans, so they're probably important. So let's go visit them. Should be due east of here. Leaving solar system. Or core word, they call it. Is that it? Yeah, I think that's it. That's probably them right there. Friendly, I guess. Yep, we're Mechan 9. Respond. It's going to show that your vessel is derived from the Empire technology. Do you confirm? Sure. You have been delayed. We are not programmed for this since... Okay, sure. Answer no questions. Okay. Piss them off or what? You look like headphone jacks. Like the headphone plugs there. Answer no questions. Are you group 9? Yes. Heaven awaits. Are you prepared? Sure. Do you serve Layton? Sure. Uh-oh. That was not the answer they wanted. That was definitely not the answer they wanted. Alright, so we don't want to serve Layton. Damn Professor Layton and his puzzling ways. These guys must have been fooled by his puzzles and just never liked them since. Nothing seeing, nothing interesting here. It's Blue Planet though. This might be their homeworld. So I guess we have to answer these questions and correctly, so it's gonna be fun. We must verify. Okay. Ask your question. We have waited long for Noah. Shall we continue to do so? No, I am Noah. Maybe. So your desire that we maintain cold blue. Oh yeah, that note there. Okay, so they're currently in code blue, and when we arrive, they're supposed to go into code red, so let's say no. Sorry that we maintain code blue? No. Let's go to code red. Do you verify code red? Yes. We have been delayed. We are not programmed for this contingency. Let's verify. Do you keep answering questions or what? Enemy of Noah. No. Seemed to be a good thing. Our databanks, ready to dispose of. Nice. Alright, so now we should be able to ask questions. Our mission was to establish the underground colony of heaven. We are to be followed by you, Group 9, 1 year later, but you did not arrive. I'm sorry. They're dead. It's been 1200 years since they've been dead. Left Earth in 3479. Sent out by the Institute with instructions for standard NOAA project procedure. Control the area with 8 sectors of heaven system and repel any invaders after heaven was established. Within 8 sectors of the heaven system. That's probably the system we're in right now, because it's really the only... like their entire sphere of influence is basically this system. So it's probably heaven right here that we're in. We just surrounded. So these guys probably have some decent information. Heaven was marginally inhabitable. It was necessary to complete terraform and engineer suitable biota. So it must be a really good place to... So establishment here, we have been attacked 14 times. Twice has been necessary to retreat underground and rebuild ourselves. Alright, let's ask about other races. Nope, don't terminate here. No. Want more information! More information! Alright. Just gotta meet them again. But it seems like they're happy now. I'm not sure if that made everybody happy, or if we have to answer questions like each group that we meet. Any day now. Any day now. Come on. Alright, oxygen, water, it's good minerals, good biomass. G, moderate to Arctic tropical calm, this is like a perfect planet to log. Boom. There's probably something good on this planet. One question is where? Good old needle in the haystack thing. That's tin, which isn't really worth much, but... bit of minerals over there. skill level critical. Magnesium, cobalt, lots of stuff right here. Fill up our inventory before we run out of fuel. And come on, come here, Simon. Nope. Cobalt is good. Oh, lots of cobalt. So if there's any artifacts on this planet, it's gonna be like finding them in the haystack, but it's one thing about, I hate about damn artifacts. I wonder if there's any way of scanning for artifacts. Maybe there's an artifact that lets us find artifacts on like the world map or something. Magnesium. Alright, let's get out of here. Wanna meet some more robots, more mechans. Hey, POCD. Hydrogen, helium, sodium compounds, tin, silver, magnesium. Let's land on the hot planet. No. Zinc, platinum, nickel. Inferno to Inferno. Nice and hot. Alright. So we need to meet some more mechans, get some more information out of them. Leaving solar system. There we go. So let's see if all of them are friendly now that we like made the other guys happy. Damn it. So we gotta go through that spiel every time. So we know that Noah is good, Layton is bad. We gotta go to the Brave New World, so. Yes. Yes. Okay. Last one more question, and we're like good to go. Yes. Our databanks are now open. Ulick passed through this region moving outward ever 1,000 years ago. Last ship was seen in 3603. Fortunately, they did not find heaven. We do have directions on how to get past the Ulick. So I'm assuming the Ulick is like the big baddies, I guess. So maybe they're the ones that are causing solar flares. Because the Spigen gave us like a secret entrance to the like middle of their territory, so. Actually, did not find heaven. It's four ships, two elect ships, 35 of 40. They possess powerful weapons. Yeah, so we probably don't want to run into those. Gazetoid or many tentacled aquatic creatures live in tremendous colony ships. Yeah, they're bastards. This guy's not turning. Aw. Alright, so. Try to get some information, like some coordinates or something. Maybe we have to ask him about the ancients and empire and all that. Of course, gotta meet a bunch of them in order for that to happen. Let's go back in here. Oop, okay, good. Oops. There's a delay after each thing, you have to wait for them to reply. You gotta wait for them to say something else. Serve Leighton, no I do not. Leighton bad. No, Noah is here, I am Noah. Or something. Is it your desire to retain Code Blue? No. Go to Code Red. What? Why? Damn it. Talk to him again. Want some more information? Maybe it's the same group we ran into, so. Give them all the right answers, they're just. They're just like, enough of this. We don't want to speak to you. You human. Require group 9. Okay, good. This guy was like nice right off the bat, so I can hold up fire. Get along for your group. Okay. The first wave of attacks on the Empire was by Numlocks and Pugmen starting 3000. Second wave comprised of Lulak and Gazertoid starting 3400. Both came from Coreward. I already have that information. Europe sends certainty factor that the Numlocks of Lem races have been completely destroyed by the Empire. Presence here indicates that the Empire has survived. Time of our departure, the probability of this was very low. Oops. In the Wars of the Flamac, many worlds of the Empire were destroyed by their black egg planet bombs. I already have a location of a great egg. So black egg is a bomb. I'm assuming that's what this great egg. The Velox gave me this information. Great egg is at 192-152, made by the ancients. Bomb. This is a planet bomb. So we have to blow up a planet. The economy of the Empire is based on Endurium. When we left, the richest and strongest planet was New Scotland. The second planet in the upspin end. Oh, nice. Staff. So I know where the Staff constellation is. So that's what. That's why there's a picture of that in the manual. Alright, so New Scotland. So second planet. Upspin is. What direction is upspin? Is that north? Yeah, upspin is north. Staff Nebula. Or Staff Constellation. Equals Endurium. It's a good place to go. I'll definitely have to go there. One of those was heard by Leighton. Leightonites believe the Empire was evil and should die. They're enemies of Project Noah. They are enemies. That's why they don't like Leighton. Empire morale was broken in 3440 when the offensive headquarters on Mardin 2 were destroyed by Ulek. Hey, Arctic. Mardin 2. Where's this Mardin 2? So there's an underground station on Earth. Where's Earth? Toot. Underground station on Earth. Gotta find Earth. 12 North, 104 West. If anybody's gonna have the location of Earth, it's gonna be these guys. Yeah, I've already encountered one of these probes. These probes are actually pretty good. Robocop, yeah. First wave of attacks on the Empire was by Numlux. No, he's repeating himself now. Durium was first discovered in some ancient ruins on Sol 4 in 2100. So that's the fourth planet of Sol, aka Mars. So it's probably some more Durium on Mars. Well, the main goal is there's solar flares that are basically destroying the galaxy or whatever, like destroying stars, and your goal is to find a way to stop those. So, right now that's basically the information I have. I don't know how to stop those, who's causing it. I'm assuming the Uleks are causing it, because everything's kind of pointing towards the Uleks being like these big baddies. I've also got directions on how to get to the... how to kind of get through a secret entrance to the Ulex, like to the center of the Ulex space, and you know, these black eggs that can destroy planets. So I'm assuming I have to destroy a planet. I already have the location of a black egg, so you need to pick that up and then find the planet, put it on. So that's what I've gathered so far, anyways. But completely off here. Strange crystalline lumps of Endurium are always found in ancient ruins. Yes. These guys are great founts of information. Ah. Actually, that guy lasted a long time before terminating communications. Better talk to these guys again. Stop chasing me!
Leaving solar system.
Good. This is one of the guys we've already met, so it makes it a lot easier. To re-answer questions again. Yes, I'm aware of that. Just answer my damn question. Ruins of the ancients have been found all over space, but primarily seem to be in M-type planets, M-type systems. There are many hundreds of millions of years old. So, basically look for blue planets, which I kind of figured as much, but... it's not going to be like, visiting every blue planet looking for it. Institute based at 75S66. East on Akerton 6. I don't know what the hell Akerton 6 is. There's much controversy surrounding their findings. They often worked with the Elemen. So the Elemen would be a good person to ask for that. They might give us information about where Earth is, and uh, Ask LO1. There were several popular theories about the ancients. One was that they traveled the universe, seeding life and leaving Endurium. Another belief is that they will one day return to judge mankind. It's believed that the device known as the Crystal Planet was built by the... Okay. Crystal Planet, then. So that's probably the planet I need to use the bomb on. So, Crystal... Planet. So maybe that's the cause of the solar flares? Is a device there? It's the Death Star. Vast City of the Ancients. Okay, I already found that. It's thought to be on the innermost planet of the system. Yeah, I already found that one. Nice. Ruins at 36 north, 90 east. Nice planet. That's where we're going next. Hopefully this is going to be an artifact. Okay, that's repeating themselves now. General info. Society of Scientists and other intellectuals convinced of the Empire's impending destruction. Institute discovered an increase in instability of stars coreward. There are many references to our databanks to the encroaching dead zone. When we left Earth, the Institute was studying Sol for anomalous radiation emissions. Tell me where Earth is! Sol is, of course, in the Pythagoras constellation. Okay. Sol in... I don't know where the Pythagoras... It's gotta be a triangle of some kind. Pythagoras constellation. Let's take a look at the star map here. So it seems like most constellations are like very close clustered stars. Let's take a look here. So there's one close, like kind of strictly south of here. There's like three stars grouped together. Really? Not really. The staff up there. There's another one kind of all the way east of us, a little bit south. It's pretty far though. So let me mark. So here and here, possibly. Seems to be the two most logical. It's like three stars grouped close together in a triangle. There's one over here as well. Kind of like an equilateral triangle style. Should be most likely what... I mean, it could be other styles, but it seems like Pythagoras theorem is using like triangles in that usually, so... This could be a triangle. Damn it. Alright, let's go get that, the ruins here.
Entering solar system.
Our data banks are open. Fine, just tell me. Hold on, wait long for your turn. Alright, just tell me what I need to know. This is a Starflight research station in the center of North Pole on Mars. Is that the 75 South, 66 East? No, that's our cont number. North Pole. Because of a lot of info. First NOAA mission, NOAA 1 failed because of a ring device malfunctioned, resulting in instability to identify continuum fluxes. Inability to identify continuum fluxes. Well, so there's a ring device, maybe? That's good for identifying fluxes. Maybe it just lets us see where all the fluxes go without having to go through them. So one in one of the planets, so runes at 28 north, 4 east on one of the planets, a planet nearby system. Not sure what the class G is, but there's a nearby system, like there's only one system that's pretty close to here, so it's most logically the one they're talking about. Basically because it is within Veloxy space and is guarded by a drone. Okay. Veloxy space is like that sphere, so yeah. It's gonna be the one they're talking about. Drone though might be a bad thing. Oh, we got some badass shields in that, so. So here's Society of Scientists and Other Intellectuals. Okay, they're repeating themselves. Alright, that's pretty good info, so. So we know, we have an idea where Earth is. It's in the Pythagoras constellation. We've got to find where that constellation is. Got some ruins on a nice planet we gotta go visit. So the places, there's three stars here, this might be the Pythagoras one. There's, I don't think they'd be like far apart like this. I think all the constellations are like clustered like really closely together, so I don't think it'd be stuff like this here. There's another three over here. There's the staff place we need to go to here. There's another group, where is it? Is this one? It's kind of far apart though. Closer on the actual star map. Yeah, I thought maybe these ones, but they look kind of far apart now looking at them. Because see, these ones are just like one square apart. So I think most of these constellations be like one square apart. These ones are nice and tidy, you know, like one, 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 like that. These ones are kind of more slapdash. So this one might be more likely as a Pythagoras. Is there any other... So three of them are here, but that's just a straight line, so that might be an interesting constellation here. So probably something that's going to lead us to this one. It's like two stars one beside the other here. So another kind of bunch of stars here. There's like four and so this one looks the most interesting just from the shape of it. It's a nice like right angle. Well, this one wouldn't be a right angle. Exactly, that's what I'm thinking. So this definitely looks like Just from the shape, you know, nice right angle. So it's very likely to be the Pythagoras one. So I might have to visit that one. Of course, it's kind of far. I'm hoping there's... what's the coordinates here? Let me look it up in the... let me look up the manual here. See if there's a wormhole that leads close to there. We don't have to use as much fuel. It's my manual. The big wrench. Alright, so 215.87, 235, 229. Okay, so when the 217.80 goes to 176.123. It's actually right near the staff, so that's the one we want to take. So that one should lead right to that Pythagoras area. And we gotta go to the staff galaxy anyways. It's 176.123. So is there anything else close to that? There's 178.127, which leads to 189.190. 189. No, it's even further away. And there's nothing else that's close to there. So we can just fly over here and then warp over there. So we gotta go to there anyways. So first thing we gotta do though is check out these two planets nearby. Where are we? Where the hell are we? Is this the same place? Why is the outer thing? What the hell? It's like a bunch of orbits that, with no planets. I think we broke. I think we screwed up the game somehow. That I pressed something which somehow showed orbits that aren't there. It's weird. That's pretty cool, just the fact that, you know, there's a lot of things you can explore and...
analyzing.
Alright, 10G, okay, so we gotta be careful when we land. Nope, get back there. Oh. All the colors are messed up too. I think we screwed something up. Because this used to be just like all. It didn't used to have pink and blue. Okay, so we want to land 36 north, 90 east. 36, 90 east. I think we're right about there. That's all there is, just some Endurium. Whatever. I'll take it. Some extra fuel, why not? Is that all there is around here? Oh, it did show that the minerals were zero, so not what I'm even scanning here. I know, that's one of the reasons I enjoyed Mass Effect 1 over Mass Effect 2, in that Mass Effect 1 had a mode like this here. I mean, it had stuff where you could land on planets, get resources, and that was a fun part. I really enjoyed that part of Mass Effect 1. Of course, Mass Effect 2 and 3 didn't got rid of that. But they definitely... it definitely feels like they took inspiration from this game for that part of it. It's the same idea, you know, you land on the planet, you just... drive around, picking up resources, and I think there's artifacts even that you could find in that. Really enjoyed that part of the game. Mikko, that's it, yeah. It's been a long time since I played it, but it's a really awesome part of the game.
Leaving solar system.
Come on, leave me alone. Yep. That's why it sucked that they got rid of in Mass Effect 2. I spent hours just driving around planets and finding all the nooks and crannies. It's so fun. Alright, so this is the one here where it's, well, there's only two planets, so it makes it easy. 28 north, 4 east. This looks habitable, maybe. There's that probe. One note I have here, 6 is the number of ancients. So maybe we have to say yes to anything that's like a divisible by 6. Because these guys just speak numbers, and then eventually we piss them off. 39 is not divisible by 6, so I think. No, definitely not. 72 is divisible by 6. 19 is not. 61 is not. Although there is a 6 in it, maybe. No, okay, good. 99 is not. I think. Yeah, 39, no. 11, no. 11, no. They're not shooting at us, it's a good sign. So yeah, so it looks like you have to say, you have to answer every time they have anything divisible by 6, you have to say yes, anything not divisible by 6, you don't. Always paste the review notes after, before streaming, it's like, yeah. It's the number of the ancients. These probes seem to be probes of the ancients, so. Any day now. Come on, get out of there. Okay, is this guy still chasing me? Like, why can't I exit here? Come on! What the hell? To go this way? Like... how far do I need to go before I can exit this place? Did I break the game or something? I didn't save recently, did I? Okay, seriously here, I should be more than far enough to be able to escape this guy. Do I have to kill him or something? Okay, there we go. Took forever, jeez. Save before I go too far here. Okay, something does break. Orbit, please. Orbit. Orbit. Orbiting is such a pain sometimes. Sometimes it just happens, sometimes it's like you're fighting with it. Seems to be a good planet so far. Water, oxygen, lots of biomass, lots of minerals. Moderate to Arctic, moderate, yes. Good place to log. Alright, so let's go check it out. So we want to check out 28 north, 4 east. 28, 4 east, 28. Close enough. I hate doing that, bouncing. I see an artifact. Ooh, a black egg. Jeez. Alright. Well, I guess we don't need the other one. Unless we need like multiple black eggs to blow up the planet. Very possible we do, so. That was easy. Should definitely pick up the rest though, I mean. Or go to the crystal planet once we figure where the hell it is. Crystal planet's gotta be in the space there, the Utek space, so. Everything kind of pointing towards there. Out of fuel, returning to ship. Made it. Nice. And we're going far on no fuel. Alright, let's get out of here. Artifacts. Planet bombs drop on planet. Alright. So yeah, I don't know if we need multiple ones of these, but we do have location of another one, so I don't know how many there are. So this is done. This is done. Okay. So let's go to the plant, the staff constellation here. Save. Let's see where this goes for the hell of it. Alright, this brings us right back home, actually. Convenient. Doesn't really bring us close to anything. Well, it kind of brings us. Yeah, we can fly over here. See if that's the Pythagoras. Then we can teleport to the staff. It's really the same thing. And we need 9 fuel, 10 fuel, give or take, to get here. Check out these other places while we're here. Orbit damage. Nitrogen or hydrogen, NH3. Yeah, some expensive stuff. Platinum, silver, titanium. Oops, didn't notice how many minerals. 15.
Analyzing.
I don't really need money. As long as we can buy fuel. And from the way that they're describing the New Scotland there, that might be a good place to pick up a bunch of Endurium anyways. Plutonium, silver, tungsten. Yeah, that's fine. Let's get out of here. Get out of here.
Leaving solar system.
Almost there. Alright, so yeah, this definitely looks like Pythagoras Triangle.
Entering solar system.
1, 2, 3. Oh, this looks like a potential. I mean, third planet from the sun looks like Earth, and then the one after that looks like Mars. I mean, they're rocky planets. So, very possible. Is this Venus? Venus is rocky, though, so. Maybe not. But definitely, I mean, it has the right number of planets, so this is not Sol. It's a yellow star. It's very likely. No atmosphere. Well, it definitely isn't Venus, but not the Venus that we know of now, but maybe in the future. Nitrogen, oxygen, yeah, definitely an Earth-like planet. If it ain't Earth, it's pretty damn close. If it's got 1G, then... Yeah, 1G, yeah, it's definitely Earth. Alright, so is there anything on Earth? Yeah, there is the underground station. And then we gotta go to Mars on North Pole. Was this, what else was there on Earth? Yeah, if this isn't Earth, I don't know what is, right? Okay. Station 12 North, 104 West. Definitely Earth. Hypercube. I wonder what the Hypercube is. Second shipment of iridium to arrive. Mardan 2. It's Mardan 2. I wonder if that's one of the other places of this Pythagoras then. Because everything points to Mardan 2. So, 56 North, 16 West. At Mardan 2. Earth? 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 Yeah. We're the Earthians, so. We're the Earthlings. Of log. People are panicking, the solar flares are intensifying. Estimates gives us 3 days at the outside. Entry surface temperature is 150 degrees Celsius. Only being this far underground has kept us alive this long. Cornerstone inscription, Ben and Anna's Academy of Independent Thinking. Alright. So I guess some minerals over here, if there is any. Promethium. Let's go to the US. Because I say we're moving across the ground pretty damn fast. Hey look, there's no wall between the US and Mexico. It's supposed to be an alternate future. Mercury. Oh! Newspaper, lovely lunar landscapes. Own your own home in these final years after retirement. Live in quiet serenity at the Sea of Tranquility. Crater-side homes are now available at the start of only 69 million MU. Senior citizens, 200 years up and only. It's a random thing. Must reach! Damn it! Let's go to Japan! Wait, this is... yeah, this place was made... this game was made in the US, so there wouldn't be anything on Japan. Japan's probably not even here. But it doesn't exist. Let's go to Europe. Maybe something in Europe. That's minerals. UK isn't even there. UK doesn't exist! Although technically, you know, if the temperature reached 150 degrees, the polar ice caps probably melted. Actually, that's probably the UK right there, that little island thing. Wait, that's not an island. I saw ruins! Let's go! Magazine, May 3rd, 3450. An interview yesterday. George Schmeng, the donor of the first successful brain transplant, has little to say. Yeah. Seems like anything else in here is just... nothing important anyways, just random tidbits of uselessness. So let's get out of here. Prometheum. Alright, so let's go to Mars. Ethanol, ethanol, aluminum, chromium, rhodium. Oops. Alright, we want to land on... Mars has water, what? what was the coordinates? North Pole. Jeez, couldn't get any closer than that, jeez. Ring device, alright, this is the ring device we're talking about. Starflight navigation. Oh yeah, I gotta check out what that hypercube does too. Starflight Navigational Research Station. Oops. Let's get out of here. Alright, let's see what these artifacts do here. Hypercube. Shows nearby encounters on star map. Well, that's handy. Ring device. Shows nearby flexes on star map. Okay. Cool. Alright, so we can knock those off. So we found Earth. I want to find Mardon 2, though. Maybe another system in the Pythagoras. Cendurium on... oh yeah. Check Mars, see if there's any Endurium anywhere. Maybe some other ruins over here. It's like land, I don't know, here. I don't know if you can mine Endurium or if it just shows up on the ground. The description seemed to be like only on ground, like only at ruins you'll find Endurium. So I don't think you can actually mine it, but... Premium is worth a lot of money, though. There, something like right here. Like sitting on top of it. Don't see any Endurium. I guess those like red dots are Endurium. Or red, kind of like orange triangle things. Seen one yet, so of course that's just because they found some before doesn't mean there's any left. Could have mined them all out, so which would make sense. Level critical. Let's get out of here. Alright, so that's it for the solar system. So Mardon 2. So maybe this one? This might be Mardon. G landable, but be careful. 56 north, 16 west. 56 north. Close enough. No. We would see it right now, so. Let's just see if there's anything over here. Nope. Maybe like right here or something. So this definitely isn't Mardon. Get over here. This one, I mean, is an Earth-like planet, blue planet, so could be Mardon. Oxygen, hydrogen, hydrosphere. Yeah. That doesn't look like a very habitable planet, but. Analyzing. If it wasn't for the hydrosphere not being water, it might actually be good. Alright. Land. 56 north. By 16 west, pretty much. There. Oh, that's gotta be it. This is Mardon 2. Hereby request that the researchers at the Mars Polar Station be directed to look into this and notice that all personnel on Earth Base 1 at. Earth Base 1. Oh wait, never mind, that's the base we were at. Start play quarantine due to request mining stations 25 through 158 on planet 4, quest media supplies. Okay, so this doesn't give us the coordinates here. Planet 4 though, so there's some good mining opportunities, I guess, on Planet 4. I don't care! I got unlimited fuel! Wahaha! Planet 4 would be 1, 2, 3, 4 would be the ice planet over there. Hydrogen, oxygen, water. Got a lot of minerals.
Analyzing.
It's actually a decent planet, actually. Lots of money by the time we get back home. That's what, three plans we've logged? Alright, so they didn't specify anywhere. So let's just land somewhere, grab a bunch of materials. Plutonium. Some expensive stuff. Tornado. Lead. Plutonium. Big thing over here. Guys, tornadoes are annoying. Yeah, I don't want to lose money. Apparently they penalize you if you log in like a bad planet. Better yet, log a gas giant. This planet's perfect. It's only 25 Gs. Lots of nice materials in this plant. Wee. Wind plus ice. Ah. That's gonna keep us going there. I got enough materials. Let's get out of here. Alright. So now we gotta go to the Staff Nebula thing. So it should be a... Oh, we should be able to see it now. Should be a... I'm not sure if these are all... Teleporters? Like all... I guess it just shows you when you're close. So this is just like a wormhole, I guess. Down here. It's really big on the map. What the hell is this thing? New enemy? This might be the obsequious, or the whatchamacallit dudes. Too many damn alien names here, it's hard to keep track. Ulek. Maybe these are the Ulek. You're just talking binary. Run away! Staff Nebula, or Staff, whatchamacallit. Alright, so... Save that before we go too far. North end of Staff, second planet. Should be a lot of Endurium. It's New Scotland.
Scanning.
Pretty sure we've been here before, because some good stuff.
Analyzing.
Navigator land. Pick a random spot. I don't know. We'll have to find some. I have to find some ruins. A needle in the haystack as usual. It'd be nice to actually dig up Endurium, but I don't think that's possible. I think you can only find it on the ground. Damn, found a lot of rhodium there. It's like the next most expensive thing. What the hell? And lightning keeps hitting us here. Edgemon is worth a lot too. Let's go find some ruins. Really hate having to find random stuff on the planet. It's gotta be something that lets you find artifacts or something from the ship or even on the map. So you can't spot anything on the map in terms of like minerals or durium or anything like that. I'm needle in the haystack, isn't it? I love these needles. These needles are pain in the ass to find. Doesn't really matter anyways, I'm gonna be heading back to our home planet, so this rhodium is gonna be pretty good amount of money. I'll just buy some fuel, that's all. Nice to get some free fuel, but considering how difficult it is to find anything on a planet, unless they point you to the exact coordinates, it's just not worth it. Orders report immediately to base at 5922. East. For new orders from Harrison, the next 59 North, 22 East. Just dig in so we don't get hit by these lightning storms. Holy crap. Is it over? Really? We have finally located Harrison's base of operations on New Scotland, but once again he's a step ahead of us. I believe he may be relocated at 44 South, 137 West. First planet of system. 8198 first planet. We'll proceed to. Oh, what's this? Rod device. Coordinate listing at 5922, base 2 at 54 North. 922 we just found. 54 North, maybe the other base, 54 North. 13 East. Thomas Isle at... Oh, it's actually pretty close here. Oh, this is the one we just found. It's a RUD device, wonder what that does. Damn. This place does not like us. Damn it. Jeez. Trying to find a spot to dig in. Keep hitting rocks. Huge chunk of uranium. Alright, so we gotta go to that place. 981-98, first planet. Just run out of fuel here so we can go back to our ship. So we didn't find Enderium, but we found a lot better, and we found an artifact, which I don't know what it does, but we'll find out very shortly. And we found coordinates for something that's probably even more important. I don't know. Anything that any place that sends you somewhere else is probably an important place. Alright, RUD device. Supercharges lasers. Alright, good during combat, I guess. Okay, so 8198. Did we already... Okay, that's the Velox focusing stone. I was wondering, like, that sounds familiar. We haven't gone there yet, though, so... Velox mentioned that place to us, so... Oh, damn it. Hitting the wrong button. Alright. So... 8198... So that's this one right here. Just close to our home base, so... Let's ignore it for now. So we found this 5619 and Mordon 2. So this found that. This is Ackerton 6. I don't know what Ackerton 6 is, but. Second planet, got that. Alright, so let's go to this Velox focusing the stone thing. Might be important.
Leaving solar system.
Alright, so we have this one over here, and we have another one over here. Let's go see where these go. Kind of goes really far. I'm assuming they only show you the ones that aren't visited yet, so. So this one we went through, so there's probably another one around here. Maybe. Due east of us. Hey, what's this? Oh, those are like ships, I guess. Okay, where are we now? What part of space are we? Star map. We're not any part of no known territories, anyways. Kind of interested to go check out that ship, though. So I should go over here and just see if any of these bring me back closer to home. Although I could, if all else fails, I can just fly over here and take that one back home. Should be enough fuel. Before we do that, let's save. Save as one here. Let's see the ship. Ship moved away.
Entering solar system.
No idea where we are. It's a ship. I don't know what that symbol was. I'm not sure if that was like a, I guess an alien symbol or. These ones. Taking us further and further away here. Middle of nowhere. Almost getting back home. Pretty close to home, actually. I think that's home. It's hard to tell now with all these damn. Yeah, that's home right there. So let's go. Yay! We found a shortcut home, sort of.
Entering solar system.
All right, let's go dump all these materials. Then we gotta make our way to that focusing stone thing. Well, we got more money than we'll ever need. Megapedes. Hypercube. Buy a lot of fuel here. Let's buy 100 units of fuel. Should be enough. Good enough. That should last us until, I don't know, until we don't need it anymore. Yeah, the rod, it supercharges lasers. So, good for shooting weapons, I guess. Nice, 45,000. So, 25,000. 35,000, we got even more money now. 45,000. Tons of money. Warning. Just has lost another ship. This time it was coordinates 192 and 52. Ships in this area may wish to investigate. 192, 152, lost ship. Okay. Let's get out of here. Let's buy... Can't afford photon torpedoes. I want to get phasers. Set phasers on stun. Yeah. I don't think I really like. It's rare that I actually fight. Most of the time I'll just run like hell. So I don't think I really need to buy any weapons. War. What's it good for? So we want to go to 8198. Yeah. So 8198. So we want to go to this one here, which we could just fly there from here. We don't even need to use any shortcuts. A whole lot of these guys here. So let's go.
Leaving solar system.
Okay. First planet. At least we have coordinates. Oops. I was looking at my notes. Because the Velox told us, you know, there was focusing stone here, but didn't tell us the coordinates. Now at least we have the coordinates of where the focusing stone is. So it still was a bonus by... it's a good thing we actually went to the other place. What else? I've been looking forever trying to find a specific spot in this damn planet. Because we know how hard that is. Seems to be a colonizable world too. Good minerals, good biomass,
analyzing.
Good gravity, moderate weather. Yep. Log it.
Planet log.
All right, so we want to go 244 south. By 137 west, right here. Another artifact. Ellipsoid. Good. Ships. Hate those bird things. They really like to murder us. Analysis. Artifacts. Ellipsoid. Makes Velox friendly. Okay. Doesn't really... Well, maybe they'll give us some more information now that they're friendly. Whatever. Okay. So we got this... the egg at... at 192, 152. Oh, that's actually the place, same place they lost ships, so. Let's go check that place out. I don't know. I know there's a crystal planet somewhere, which I'm assuming is what's probably causing the solar flares. We've got a planet bomb and black egg. Well, there's a second one, so I don't know if we need multiple ones. But I don't really know where the crystal planet is yet. I'm assuming because the Speggy gave us a back way into the Ulex space. Ulex seems to be like the big baddies in this game, from what I've gathered so far from talking to the different races. So there's a secret entrance to the backyard. So I'm assuming if there's a crystal planet, it's probably gonna be near the exit of that secret entrance. Only question is where, and, you know, I need more information for that. but still a couple of races I haven't talked to, like the Elowin, for example. They probably have some good information, so and maybe the Velox will be nicer now that they're friendly. So yeah, there's lots of. So I don't know how close I am. I don't know if you know. I'm a couple like hours away. I'm a couple minutes away. I don't know. It's hard to tell. All right. So 192, 152, 192, 152. Be like right here. This green one here. So what's the quickest way? Got this teleporter here. Teleport. So if we teleport this one, take this one, and this one, and this one, and then this one, that'll take us pretty close to it. So we'll go back home first. See how friendly they are now? Alright, yeah, it's Peggy, never mind. I think I've already asked all the questions I can for these guys, so. Yeah, so the Ulik territory, so. And the city inches, like these guys, I'm pretty sure I got all the information I can from the Speggy, so. They tell us about the city inches, tell us about the secret thing. I mean, it's probably like good chunks of information you get from certain races, and then once you get that information, it's pretty much it. But I do want to speak to the Velok again now that we have this. Although I think most of the information I got from the from these guys, I already had that before I even got the thing that made him friendly or obsequious. Alright, back home, let's save. So I'm gonna take the teleporter that's down here. That's the right one? I think so, yeah. I'm gonna take this one down here. And then this one over here. And then this one here, and then finally this one here. Over here, let's check out what this one goes. I wonder if any of these I'm going through is actually the ones that bring us into the other territory. 28, 24. No, it doesn't look like anything close. It just takes us there. Really? Teleported through like two, one after the other. So we're gonna go this way. Like right on top of it. Where the hell's the dot? I might be inside. Okay, that's right. It's inside. You don't see the lines when they're going through nebula, so. Alright, so now we should be near, so we want to go here. So straight north.
Entering solar system.
Right, did it say system is flared? Not a bad thing. That means we like lost out on potentially whatever could happen here. And the atmosphere is gone. Oh, Endurium. It's a whole lot of Endurium in here. So what was supposed to be here is a bunch of launched ships. Oh yeah, great egg, that's right. I don't know where, but there's an egg somewhere on here.
Analyzing.
A whole lot of Endurium. Searing to Inferno. Computer seems to be overheated. Can't select the landing site, damn it.
Temperature increasing.
Okay, I gotta get out of here. This place already flared, so.
Leaving solar system.
Yeah, system is flared, so I guess we can't.
Leaving solar system.
Once the system is flared, it's too late. So I guess it's time based too, we gotta be careful. Ah, that sucks. Okay, what are these things? They only speak in binary, so these must be the Ulek, maybe. Somebody translate that for me fast. What's he saying? He's saying prepare to die, humans. Not very talkative. Alright, so. Just see if there's any other point of interest before we go check out the. Life forms on planets. I want to check out the Elowin. So the Elowin, I think, are over here, I think? I think that's the Elowin space around here. So, from home, let's just reload here, because there's nothing, there's no point going to this planet since the sun has already flared. Ben had a lot of Endurium on it. That's probably because of the solar flare, though. Alright, so we want to go. Stop pressing that button. There. So we want to go down here. So. Not this one, this one, I think. So let's go to these places here. I think this would be the Elowin area. It's because it's right next to the Thrawn area, so. New ships, so might be the right ones. Nice. We have Elowin communications officer, so it should really help. Now, but few of us remain, for the sun's flare did our second homeworld destroy, as well as we are preyed upon the Thrin, relentless and cold. I could care less about you. Give me information about the old empire and the ancients. Thrin and Elowin first were taken to Empire. The Thrin nurtured a profane seed, sale of head fruit on the black market quick became a tenacious weed that survived to the final days of the Empire. Asian ones who are no more, the oldest of all races. Little do we know of them for the songs of the, but for the songs of the minstrels. 'Twas from another galaxy far distant that they came, or so it is sung. Thrin and Elwyn first were taken to the Empire. The Thrin nurtured the profane seed. Okay, yeah. Same thing. Ancients. Mr. Songs be true, the span of an ancient one's life was not measured in years, but rather in millennia. So long lived were they. Fellocks and their boastful pride lay claim to be descendants of the ancient ones. Heed not such conceitful folly. Come on, give me something good here. Knowledge of the ancient ones, there is another theory to explain nature, perhaps only the Delassa Aliano, the face of truth. Yep, I have none more about the ancient ones than the Institute of the Old Empire of Earth, but alack, the fall of the Empire, the knowledge was lost. For none, not even we, knew the location of this final hiding place among the stars. Well, I found it. Didn't help us much, but well, we did get a bunch of artifacts, including a black egg. Akraton, Gaul, Sidian, Ect. These are the sons of the four seedlings. Constellation or Demst often uses name marked by people, so we need to go to Akraton 6. Something about the Institute there. So Akraton is part of the Seedlings constellation. That's in the manual as well. It's for it's four planets close to each other. I don't think I have any notes about Gaul or Redanian Ect though, so. Same answer. We now depart. Fine. Alright, so let's find that seedling's place. It's obviously nearby. Not sure if they were in a nebula or not. Yeah, they're in nebula. So probably in here. It's like four stars, one next to each other. Well, they got the coordinates 167, 84. 80. Is it 84 or 34? That wouldn't be 84. Or no, it could be. 6784, yeah, could be right in here. Or it could be 167. Could be this one here, maybe. I don't know what the first number looked like. It looks like an 84, but. I'll check out both constellations. This one's in their territory. This one isn't, as far as I can tell. Maybe the coordinates are just wrong in the map, in the manual. Actually, neither of them. Yeah, this one's actually in their territory. This one isn't. It has to be just on the edge of their territory, so it's got to be that. Let's go there. Oh yeah, definitely. This is definitely a very deep game for the time. And this is like a 5-year-old game too, like this came out 5 years before that. There we go, 4 seedlings. So we need to go Ackerton. Know which one Ackerton is. Ackerton. Go to Ackerton 6. So, obviously, you're playing with six planets.
Entering solar system.
So, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Thinks this one down all the way down over here. Orbit number 6. Yeah, let's cover the one. We don't have. Alright, we do have 75 south, 66 east. And 66 east. Close enough. Jeez. I didn't check the gravity. Maybe this isn't Ackerton 6 then. 75 south, 66 east. Should be like right on top of it. Some good materials though. Really good materials. Alright, so let's try a different. Yeah, this is definitely the sixth planet, so. Just wrong solar system, I guess. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it's blue, so that's a good sign. Seems like most of the blue ones are the ones that have the artifacts in that, so. So this one's a very good potential. A lot of biomass. Oxygen. I just heard of oxygen and hydrogen. That's not good. It's not habitable, but.
Analyzing.
2.0 gravity. Alright, so 75 south, 66 east. 75 south. 66 east. Good enough. That's the one. Some good information, I hope. Better teleport. In short, we have devised a scheme to teleport an operative from a specially built starbase, which would be known as Crystal Base 1, to the surface of the crystal planet. Nice. So this has got to be important. Because of the problems involved in teleportation of this distance, we will not be able to retrieve the operative. Volunteer will be sent in with nuclear explosive. The black bomb. that gig. If possible, we stay in communication with Starbase. We'll locate and destroy the control center of the crystal planet. Potential problems include teleportation, reliability, insufficient explosive power, communications through the magnetic field operated by the planet, location of communication transcript, crystal base to Akerton Institute. Crystal base 1 to Akerton Institute. 14 hours since Commander McDonald was sent down. At no point have we received any communication from him. Exactly 12 hours and 11 minutes after his departure, we witnessed an explosion on the planet's surface. We are now sending out drones to test the defenses of the crystal planet in an attempt to ascertain the effect of the explosion. So we have to... Recommendation. Therefore, it is our findings that the only effective means of destroying the crystal planet is with the use of three devices. First of these, the crystal orb, is needed to nullify the defenses of the planet. So, crystal orb. Don't I have a crystal orb? Orb. It's the position of the Velox. Okay, so orb. Velox. Is known to them as the small egg. Wasn't that the one on the planet that got destroyed, though? No, there's the great egg. Which I assume was a black egg. Small egg. Second device is the crystal cone. I think I got the crystal orb though. Sounds familiar. Crystal cone doesn't sound familiar. Crystal cone. This is needed to identify from orbit the location of the control nexus. Known to be a coordinates. Oh, nice. So 29 south, 55 west. On the first planet in the system. First planet. At 20, so that's where we're going next for sure. Fortunately, this is deep in Ula. Great. The crystal planet is only vulnerable at the control nexus. Lastly, a bomb sufficient power is required. The actual force necessary is unknown, but our best estimates include something in order of the Giganaut. I'm pretty sure I have that. So I need the crystal orb, which I think I might have. Let's double check here. No, I have the streaming orb. Okay, so we need the crystal orb. We got crystal pearl. It's not the same thing, I guess. So I gotta go see the Velox. Something about a small egg. And it was the great egg was on that planet that had already been solar flared. So we've got the black egg here. So that's the explosive device. So crystal cone. It's in Ulex space. So which means probably have to use the back door. But it doesn't tell us what the crystal planet is, though. It's the only problem. It's crystal base 1, but... drones. First, these crystal orbs need to nullify the defense of the planet. Position of the Velox. So let's go see the Velox for sure. Then, I haven't seen him since I picked up that thing that made him friendly, so maybe that's going to help. Second device, the crystal cone. This is needed to identify the orbit. Nexus, that would be the coordinates there. System. Okay. So yeah, let's try go into Ulex space here. And try to get the crystal cone and then go see the Velox. Okay, so the secret entrance to their space is starts off at 10639. 106, 139. So like right here is where it starts, which is kind of close from the our starting place. So yeah, I never played it before, and it's definitely an interesting game. I like these kind of exploration games, and gives you a lot to do, a lot of things you can do, although, you know, obviously not required to really do any of it. It seems to be one of those games, like, if you know where to go from the beginning, you can finish it real quick. If you don't know where you're doing, like in my case, it can take a while, but... Okay, so we're back home. Let's just save while we're here.
Entering solar system. Leaving solar system.
Okay, so 106, 139. So kind of north. 106, 139. Oops, did not want to teleport there. Stupid things, annoying as hell. Run! Alright, so then we go 64, 186. Okay, these guys are friendly. The poets, the minstrels, whatever they're called. Come on, let us escape now. These guys aren't even in a fight, so let us go. And now we wait for an hour for this thing to let us escape. Why does it take so long sometimes? Change directions, like there. Okay, next up 35, 186. Now we should be in the middle of their space. Okay. So 2188, that's gotta be the planet right there. And then the first planet, which of course right in the middle of a nebula, which is a perfect place to be. Probably gonna be attacked here, before we get there. These guys don't seem like a friendly bunch, so probably not happy to be for us to be in their territory. Oh. Run! .5 Gs, land, 29 south, by 55 west. There we go. Crystal cone done. Let's get out of here. The device control nexus on the crystal planet. Of course, I still don't know where the hell the crystal planet is, but. Okay, so let's get the hell out of here. Full speed! Probably safe now. Alright, so next up we need to go see the Velox. The Velox area. I think right now we're in the middle of territory of like the bad guys. So Velox would be like kind of this area around here. So once we teleport back, we just have to kind of go this way and then we can get to Velox. Pretty much in their territory now, so just I don't go to a random planet and see if they encounter us. There we go. Right, these aren't the Velox, these are the Spemen. I guess we're in between both territories right now, so let's get out of the Spemen area just so we encounter Velox, not Spemen. Careless with the spinning.
Leaving solar system.
Okay. Should be pretty much smack dab in the middle of their territory now. So let's go to a random planet over here.
Entering solar system.
Being scanned. It's Philoxy, the everyday. I am Captain Tetz of exceptionally pleasant vessel, Zicto. And now perhaps the information exchanging, yes. Where's your small egg? General info. No. Maybe? I don't know if I have to give it to them? Damn it. Maybe I was supposed to give it to them. I was supposed to give that to them. Sure. Or their shields. A long time receiving old Empire distress call from system. I think I already did that one. 175.94. Yeah, I did that one. Currently guarded by Galaxy drones, most destructive. Haven't gone there yet, but didn't really take any. Didn't really seem interesting. It's just like life forms. The only egg they've mentioned that I've seen so far is that giant egg. It's supposed to be a small egg, so. 6, yeah, I'll do that. Minerals I could care less about. Give me information about your small egg. Keep repeating themselves, ancients. Okay. Great egg is made by the ancients. Of course, looking like big Deluxe egg exactly. Yeah, that's the planet that was destroyed, so can't even land there, so I'm hoping that's not the small egg that they're talking about, because I can't land there, so unless it's too late, you know, whatever happens if you're too late, like you get to the point where you can't pick that thing up anymore. I wonder if reloading and just going there might be good. Just reset the game to see what happens. Most significant hexagon on the sacred planet Sphexi is a sign from the ancients. Wondrous Veloxy descends. The small egg is there. Okay, there we go. There's a picture of the sacred, the magnificent hexagon as well in the manual, but don't know where this is going to be. Small egg at hexagon. Planet Sphexi. Secret velocity positions, absolutely. So I need to know where Sphexi is. Even if I ask them about themselves. Didn't answer my question! Where's Sphexi? Somewhere in their space, obviously, but it looks like, look in the manual, it looks like a kind of an Earth-like planet. Maybe it's that planet in the middle here. Yeah, it'd be funny if we got lucky and of course, well, the only coins I have would be the ones from the manual, so find out pretty quickly if this is the one. Has no gravity. This is point G. It's weird. Broken. Well, it's not really much of much land on this place. Let's check out the picture in the manual. Some rough coordinates. So the ruins of old Earth we found. Staff constellation we found. The city of the ancients we found. So the most significant hexagon is one of the main things that we haven't found yet. We found the four seedlings. The only other point of interest in the manual that it shows is the Axe constellation. It's maybe something in the Axe constellation we want to go check out. But, so it's like 45 north, 17 east. 45 north, 17 east. It could be. No, it'd be like middle of water. really doubt it's this place. Yeah, definitely not this place.
Leaving solar system.
Seems like most of the important ones are always inside nebulas. Which would be, I mean, this one's pretty much smack dab near the middle of their space. So, let's go check out that nebula. There's nothing in the nebula, but a couple planets. This one's like a yellow star. Repeating themselves, aren't they? Yeah. Oh, there you go. Signed voice of the ancient totally number 6, the most perfect of all numbers, and of course Phylaxia are 6-legged only race. So 6 obviously is important, so. So maybe 6th planet of something? Damn it. Is there like anything that looks like a shape of a 6? Maybe 6 planets together in like a small area? It's not really anywhere that has like 6 planets like really close to each other. Unless inside this nebula over here, it's another nebula that's inside their territory, but. Right north. Right north by 17 east. It's kind of middle of the ocean, so doubt it. No. Oh, jeez. Gravity's a lot higher than I expected. So I just have to look for solar systems that have blue planets. Alright, let me mark off which ones I've actually been to on my map here. So I've been to those 3. So let's go. There's 2 more like north of us. Whoa! Hopefully these guys don't decide to attack. this, please. It's fine. Take my fuel. This don't kill me. Alright. Obviously the great egg, very important, certainly only telling the best friends. I wonder if the crystal planet is actually the one in that, the one we tried going to there that we couldn't land on because the solar flare had already happened. I wonder if that was the crystal planet now that I think about it. Because it's the only place I've ever seen like a flare so far. They're mentioning here about the great egg and that, so I don't know. Know more about your secret planet. Oops. Not the right one. Damn it. Leave me alone. Already give me some fuel. There was, I did talk to a probe and it gave me a bunch of coordinates, habitable planets and that. I wonder if one of those is nearby. 163, no. Nothing's close. 94, 42. Some minerals on like 149, 133. That one's kind of in the territory. This one here. This one's in their territory. That's the probe. One of the probes told us is the first planet there has a bunch of minerals. So that might be a potential here. It's only one of the ones that the probe told us that's in this area. So, could go check that one out. Oh, two blue planets here. Talk to them, or else they're going to demand for us to give them some fuel. Oxygen, water, seems like a good planet. 0.9, Arctic tropical, yeah, let's actually log this one. Mostly water, but which is unlikely to be the right one because it would take us like right in the ocean, yeah. So, definitely not this place. Is not multiple of 6. 28 is not. 58 is not. 84, yeah. 25 is definitely not. 26 is not. Water, oxygen, another good planet.
Analyzing.
We have 5, tropical to inferno. Moderate. Yeah. Log it.
Planet log.
This one's more potential. It's not all water. So 45 north, 17 east. 45 north, 17 east. Yes, that's it. Nice. Centurium. Crystal orb, yay. We have all the parts now, and then we just gotta find the damn planet. Which I'm thinking might be that place we went to, so... Done, alright. So we got all the parts we need, I think, to destroy that crystal planet. Just gotta know where the hell the crystal planet is, which... If it's... What I'm thinking is gonna mean that, this one right here, maybe? Just fly there. Let's do that.
Leaving solar system.
What's the coordinates? 192, 152. That, identify control, good thing, whoa, too far. Come on, orbit, orbit, damn it, orbit.
Orbit established. Analyzing.
Oop, so it didn't let us land before, so that's a good sign. And yeah, this gotta be it. This gotta be the crystal planet because it's pointing us right here. It's gonna be GG. Log entry, Commander McDonald, entry 1. Successfully teleported to the crystal planet. I am dizzy and have experienced a profound sense of disorientation, but other than that, I seem to be fine. Control nexus is visible from here. Entry 2. It would seem that the electromagnetic field around the crystal planet is in fact blocking communications. Since it has been an hour and I still receive no transmissions from crystal base 1. Entry 2. I am therefore waiting in this log as planned. We'll attempt to find a safe place for it to before the explosion. Reach the control center and have set the charges. Appears to be a massive ruin of the ancients. Queer crystalline lumps of endurium are everywhere here. Entry 4, I just have standing experience. I can hardly believe it, but I seem to have made telepathic contact with the ancients. They are here, on the crystal planet, controlling it. Or there is some way for me to communicate what I have found. Explosion is set for T-minus 40 minutes. In the event that the crystal planet is not destroyed, I can only hope that this log is found by someone. I can hardly believe it. Those weird lumps are actually intelligent life. The ancients are endurium. Really. We have spent hundreds of years hunting them to burn for fuel. Damn. In our ships. Their metabolism is so much slower than ours. They live in an entirely different time framework. I don't think they even know that we are sentient. I believe it was only because of a link through the crystal planet that contact was made at all. Crystal Plan was their last defense. I can hardly blame them. Carbon-based life must have seemed something like a virus to them. just the same. I hope the explosion works. Looks like at this point, us or them, McDonald out. Damn, that sucks. we're just like burning these guys to death here. So, do I have to use the thing here? Like, how do I? Black egg. Drop it, maybe? I saved, right? Did I save? I don't know if I was supposed to do that. Damn it. Can't get back to the ship. Oh, guess that did it. Is that it? Is that GG? Sounds like it. That's GG. That was pretty easy, but it was a fun game for sure. Definitely different. Da, da, da. Oh, once all the clues started like kind of melting together there. Must be another egg. Have a great, great egg. It's going to eat you. It is with the sincerest gratitude from the people of Earth, the stockholders of Intracell, that I present you your heroic crew the Intracell Medal of Sublime Achievement, the highest honor accorded to Intracell contractors. Thank you for saving everything we hold dear. I know, right? You know, it's like, we're burning like these guys as fuel, and we destroy their only like their last ditched effort at surviving. Like, we're definitely the bad guys in this game. It's like it's us or them. Well, in this case, it's kind of we're definitely the bad guys here. All right, so that's game number 64 done. Yeah, I can see that game being extremely quick speedrun if you knew exactly where to go. I mean, you have to, if you know where to go for the crystal egg, the crystal rod, and the black egg, that's it. I mean, just gotta do that, go to the crystal planet, and you're done. So that'd be extremely fast speedrun. Pretty much, right? It's like, we're more important than everything else. Huh? This ancient, super intelligent life form that's been around for like millennia. Eh, we need fuel for our ships. Let's just murder them all. Alright! Let's just replays this over and over. Cool, so that game finished a little faster than I expected, anyways. Thought it'd be like a lot longer game. Yeah. And we're back.